Okay, baik. Itu sambung balik pada question number 3 for our first subsection 5.1. Okay. So, question number 3 tu, tugboat pulls a disabled super tanker. Each tug exerts a force of 1.8 times 10 to the power of 6 Newton, one 14 degree west of north and the other 14 degree east of north as the tanker moves 0.75 kilometers towards the north. So what is the total work done on the super tanker? So for this question, okay, we know that work is F dot S. So work tu pula kita kita tahu ada force. Force tu pula sekarang ni ada dua force. So again, untuk question yang force, you need to draw the free body diagram. So free body diagram dia rupa macam ni lah. Okay, they are moving okay to the north S, tapi kita ada one force which is the west of north. So this is the west of north. Kiranya ni north kita. West of north tu belah sini lah. Okay, belah sebelah north. Okay, sebelah kiri north ni. Okay, kiri north ni kita ada 14 degree. Then east of north which is belah kanan kita. Okay, east of north which is belah kanan kita pun ada 14 degree. So ada force pertama, force kedua. So when you do ada two forces kat sini, you need to have a total force. Okay, so so what I did here is work, saya cari work total lah sebab sekarang ni kita ada dua force. So work total sama dengan force total dot S. Okay, so untuk cari force total pula, kita kena ada the total component of force of one and total force on the second lah. So kat sini kita ambil cos sahaja. Kenapa kita ambil cos sahaja tak sine? Okay, sebab you know that sign, you punya sign is you moving towards the right ataupun towards the left. Tapi kita tahu tugboat tu is moving towards the north. So you just take the forces which are present on the north ataupun on the y lah. Okay, so if you resolve F2 dengan angle kita ni, okay, so moving to the north kita ada F2 cos 14 degree. Kalau kita tengok F1 pun sama, kita ada F1 cos 14 degree. So that's why I took the cos. So nak cari work total pula is F1 cos 14 degree plus F2 cos 14 degree. Okay, darab dengan S lah. Okay, what is the S? 75 kilo, kilometer, 0.75 kilometer. So 0.75 darab 10 kuasa 3 cos 0 degree. Kenapa cos 0 degree? So we're taking the north punya component, okay, ataupun the y axis punya force, and our displacement is also in the same direction. So both of them have no angle lah. Okay, so that's why cos kosong. Cos kosong pula is 1. Okay, so ni tak payah risau. Cos kosong adalah 1. So you just masukkan F1, force 1, force 2, tambahkan diorang dan darab dengan 0.75 km. You can have the answer as 2.62 times 10 to the power of 6 joule. Okay, that should be your answer lah for question number 3. Okay, so now let's go for question number 4. Okay, question number 4 ni is a bit practical lah daripada question number 1, 2 tadi. Okay, so tengok dulu question kita. So for question number 4, you push your physics book 1.5 meters along the horizontal tabletop with a horizontal push of 2.40 newton, while the opposing force of friction is 0.600 newton. How much work does each of the following force do on the book? So soalan ni dia sebenarnya nak you draw the free body diagram, but instead of kita ada macam total force or we have like net force ke untuk cari work net, kali ni kita just nak tengok satu force. Ianya work done for only one force macam mana. Okay, so the free body diagram macam ini je. Sebenarnya ada je normal kat atas. Okay, so tu pun saya tolong dulu. Okay, so ni buku kita. Okay, buku kita moving to the force towards the right of 2.40 newton, and there ada friction of 0.600, and also kita ada normal force. Okay, normal force upward, and also ada weight lah. Ada weight. Okay, sorry. Okay, ada weight situ. Sebenarnya dia inline dah width dengan normal ni. Sorry, saya punya ni tak berapa cantik. So then they moving with the displacement S towards the right. So again, we know that okay, we know that work is F dot S. So F dot S is Fs cos theta. The force here, the work done by the force, okay, the the force here is 2.40. It's moving in the same direction as the displacement. Okay, nampak tak? Displacement ni dengan force ni, okay, force tu is in the same direction. So, cos 0 degree. So, 2.40 times 1.5 times cos 0, you can have the answer of 3.60 joule. Okay. So, for question number 2 pula, dia nak frictional force. Okay, frictional force is moving towards the left, but the displacement is moving to the left, to the right. Okay, kena tahu work equals to F dot S. Our force tu, we only take the magnitude. Okay, so kat sini kita tak bubuh negatif. Tak bubuh negatif. So, kita ambil just the magnitude of the force, which is 0.600, darab dengan dia punya displacement of 1.50. Okay, now, kita tahu force friction ni negatif sebab dia moving to the left kan. So, what determines yang dia jadi negatif? Yang negatif sini bukan direction kita ambil. Kita ambil direction sini. Memanglah negatif ni. Tapi sebenarnya negatif tu datangnya daripada angle between kita punya force, frictional force ini dan displacement kita. So, kalau kita tengok frictional force kita moving to the left, tapi displacement kita moving to the right, kita ada angle of 180 degree. Okay. So, when you have cos 180 degree, okay, cos 180 degree is negative 1. So that's why kita punya friction jadi negatif. Okay, friction jadi negatif tu sebab angle kita lah. Okay, dalam F dot S ni, the force yang again kita ambil adalah kita punya magnitude saja. So jangan bubuh negatif dalam tu lah. Okay, so our work done is memang negative 0.90 joule. Negatif ni bukannya menandakan bahawa direction sebab work is a scalar quantity. Negative ni just show that the work done by the friction is in just a negative value lah kiranya. Okay, dia tak masukkan direction apa-apa, it's just a negative value work dia. Okay, so what is the work done by the normal force pula? Okay, ingat normal ni moving outwards, kita punya displacement moving to the right. So if you see normal moving outwards and displacement moving to the right, the angle between the normal and the displacement is actually 90 degrees. Okay, so normal ni tak kisah pun. Work kita adalah, no, force kita adalah normal. Kita ada displacement S, cos theta, cos 90. So, there's no work done by the normal lah. Logical lah. Okay, because something, force yang upwards ni, dia tak melakukan kerja langsung lah pada dia. Okay, dia tak letih. Okay, but the force towards the left and the right akan ada positive and negative lah. Kiranya, one force is doing positive work done by the book ataupun work done on the book lah. Okay, itu rasanya dah explore work done by and work done on. Okay, so now what does it mean for question number 4? What is the net work done, okay, on the book? So you want to find the net work done is actually the total of all the forces yang kita calculate. Okay, total means we add up all the forces lah, individual forces yang kita cari. So kita ada work daripada 1, work daripada 2 dan work daripada 3. So the total is 2.7 joule lah, adding 3.60 tolak dengan 0.90. Okay, so the negative here just shows that our work here kiranya is a negative value lah, bukannya direction tau. Direction does not have any part dalam ni. Okay, so the total work done is 2.7 joule sebab kita ada work done on the left and work done on the left by the friction and work done on the right by the force. So the total is 2.7 joules. Okay, so okay, for our final question on 5.1, okay, 5.1, kalau kita tengok sini, a 10 kilogram computer monitor is dragged by friction 5.50 meter up along moving surface conveyor belt at an inclined angle of 39 degree above horizontal. If the monitor speed is constant, okay, constant maksudnya no acceleration now, jaga how much work is done by the friction, gravity and normal force. So ini kita nak cari individual forces, same concept as question number 4. So again, for this type of question, you need to draw the free body diagram. Okay, you have the normal force moving outward, kita ada weight moving downwards, then sini ada mg cos theta. And towards the left, kita ada mg sin theta. And also, kenapa friction dia kali ni towards the right? Bukan friction ni opposed motion ke? Bukan patutnya to the left ke? Tak, sebab sekarang ni dia cakap, box 10 kg is dragged by the friction. So, the force of friction yang dragkan benda ni. Okay? So, disebabkan it's the question stated like that. So, you need to draw it like that lah. Friction yang drag the box. Okay? So, again, what is the work done by friction? Okay. We know that work is F dot S. Okay, so F kita ni adalah friction at S, cos theta. So there's friction kita moving to the right and also our displacement moving towards the right, yang kat atas lah. Okay, so from here you have summation of Fx equals to 0. Sebab again, it's moving with a constant speed, A sama dengan kosong. Okay, so what are the forces present on the X? You have the friction moving towards the right. Also you have mg sin theta. Okay, mg sin theta dekat left. So mg sini, kita ada sini, mg cos theta. Mg cos theta. Dan kita ada dekat sini mg sin theta. Okay, mg sin theta. Okay, one moving downwards, one moving to the left. So kita ada negative mg sin theta, okay, plus the force equal to 0. So from here the force is mg sin theta. So kita masukkan mg sin theta ni ke dalam kita punya work punya equation. So kita ada mg sin theta darab dengan displacement cos kosong. Cos kosong is 1. So we have all our info. M kita ada 10, g kita ada 9.81. Displacement pun dibagi sebagai 5.50. So we should be able to find our frictional force of 58.9 joule. Okay, now for question B, gravity pula. Okay, gravity tu maksudnya dia nak mg. Okay, dia nak work done by the gravity. Okay, so our gravitational force sekarang ni Fg. Okay, work is Fs, which is Fgs cos theta. Manakala Fg kita adalah mg. Okay, so Mgs cos theta. Cos theta pula sekarang ni sini adalah, okay, angle yang kecil ni is 39.9 degree tambah 90 degree. Okay, so 90 plus 36.9 degree, kita akan dapat around 120.9 lah setahu saya. Okay, so you add all the number, you should be able to get the work done as a negative negative work lah. Okay, negative 3 to 3.96 joule. Okay, so that's for question B. Okay, so physics question C, dia minta normal pula. Again, normal moving upwards and it's 90 degree, you should know this as 0 joule lah, senang je. Okay, F dot S, which is F as cos theta, but our force here is the normal and as cos theta. Okay, cos theta is cos 90, cos 90 is 0. Okay, so that's all you need to know about subsection 5.1 lah. Okay, so what you need to do is for subsection 5.1, okay, you need to know how to draw the free body diagram. Okay, untuk work equals to F dot S. Okay, Fs cos theta. Cos theta tu is the angle between force and displacement. Okay, and the force ni yang kita masuk sini is only the magnitude punya component lah. Okay, tapi kalau contohnya dia ada banyak force, you need to do the free body diagram first. Cari the total force on the X, lalu masukkan dalam komponen, ataupun total force on the Y, masukkan dalam komponen to get the work done lah. Okay, and angle tu mestilah the shortest distance, bukan the longest distance. Okay, so we shall continue after this for section 5.2, energy. Okay.